Welcome to the debut of my live-action content. This is my review of Las Vegas, Nevada, and the United States as a whole. I will be covering pretty much whatever I deem important. I would like to start with amenities and infrastructure. First of all, there was the toilet in my hotel room, which, I mean, the bowl was just fucking enormous, and also, secondly, the water level was just far too high. The splash zone, I was well in the splash zone at all times. It was unacceptable. There was also the public toilet in the hotel. The stall was just massive. You may say it was disabled, but it was the only one in there. Personally, I think it's just because they were anticipating people being fat. Then there was also a toilet in McCarran Airport, which is the NCR base in Fallout New Vegas. The toilet stalls in there, I mean, they had the hook, which is good because you need that when you're in an airport. But also the gap from the floor to the beginning of the stall, way too big. I mean, I could actually see the base of the sink. From what I remember, I mean, it was just, I felt very exposed taking a crap in there. And there was something in there I've never actually seen before, and it was weirdly dark. I mean, there I am taking a crap, and just, I see a sign for, "Are you a victim of human trafficking?" Which was in four languages. You had English, which, that makes sense. Then you had Spanish, because also that makes sense, because South America. Probably should have had Portuguese on there as well, to be fair. Then there's Mandarin, okay, it's the most spoken language. And then there was Filipino. That is oddly specific. And that creeped me out. Anyway, moving on from the shitters. I saw her last week tonight, quite a long time ago. I don't really watch John Oliver anymore because he's a liberal cuck. But they talked about infrastructure and they were all like, infrastructure's falling apart and infrastructure is not sexy was the phrase they used quite a lot. I don't know what roads these guys were looking at, but they clearly weren't looking at the same ones I was because these were damn sexy roads. And this was Boulder Highway, it was just stretched on as far as the eye could see, and then there were the other ones around Lake Mead, which granted was a national park, but I didn't see a bad road when I was there. And I'm actually quite impressed by the way they've built all their roads in the States. Everything's just built on a grid. You know, in Britain, they've built on top of old roads. It's like if you were playing SimCity and you didn't know what you were doing, and then you learned what you were doing and had to build on top of the shit you'd already built, you get Britain. Whereas the States is like you already knew what you were doing. It's really good. I'd say the only thing American towns really lack is a clear town centre for the most part, you know, present company excluded. I pretty much visited all the places that were made famous by Fallout New Vegas. I went to Red Rock Canyon, which is the home of the Great Khans. I drove past Nellis Air Force Base at one point. I went to that place you assassinate President Eden, and it's where you get most of your missions if you play for the NCR. I went to Lake Mead, which is the place you find the plane for the boomers. I went to Fremont Street as well, which I think is where Freeside is based from. Went to a place called Binion's, which is supposedly, it's like the mecca of poker. Which, I was surprised at how reverent people are at gambling. I mean, obviously gambling's not as frowned upon in Nevada, because it's kind of its lifeblood. I was surprised at how almost kid-friendly a lot of the casinos were. I couldn't really get my head around that. A lot of the machines were based on known brands. Like, there was an Ellen DeGeneres machine. Like, she's fucking there beckoning you to come and play it. I mean, for all her moral crusading, she clearly doesn't have a problem with gambling. And I mean, if Ellen DeGeneres isn't your thing, why not try the Jurassic Park machine? Or the Walking Dead machine? Or the Orange is the New Black machine? Or the National Lampoon's Animal House machine? Or the Willy Wonka machine? Or the Breaking Bad machine? Or the National Lampoon's Vacation machine? Or the fucking Anchorman machine? There's something for everyone. Speaking of vices, given the collective BMI of North America, it's pretty hard to get through a review of the place without talking about the food. First of all, I'd like to talk about sports bars, and why we don't have any of them, because they're the happiest places on the planet. You've literally got enough tellies to put every single sport on the planet. They even had football on, and I mean actual football, not hand egg, Champions League football. And we watched some cracking matches. I saw United beat PSG the other day, and that Liverpool-Bayern, that was fucking awesome. I wasn't expecting that. Also, why don't we have a Buffalo Wild Wings over here? In Britain, or Europe, like I said, it is the happiest place on the planet. They got 22 beers on tap. They had fucking Newcastle Brown on tap. That's impressive. A lot of places in Britain don't have that. And also, the wings are just goddamn delicious. You know, you just show up with a couple of mates. I saw a lot of these kind of, you know, sports teams showing up. You have a bunch of wings. They're all delicious. Boneless, easy to eat. You know, you just never stop eating them. Mouth's watering, just bloody thinking about them. I am deadly serious. If anybody's watching who has the power to give it to me, I will open the first franchise in Britain. It will be successful. I will make you rich. And it'll be delicious for all involved. At the same time, I kind of think maybe it's for the best that we don't have that kind of stuff. I mean, the eating habits over there are on full fucking display, especially when you go to Walmart. I can't go to America and not go. I know I went to Vegas, but come on, I'm going to go out of my way to go to a Walmart. Walmart is great. Having said that, walking down the breakfast aisle, I kind of get why everybody's so fat and why their legs are falling off from diabetes, because I mean, it was insane. There was like 32-ounce bags of sugary garbage. I thought they were cat food bags. Walmart is not a wholesaler, by the way. This is just a regular shop. Anyone can shop there. And fucking apparently everybody does. I understand to a lot of people internationally who've never been to a Walmart. To you, Walmart is probably just the Reddit thread people of Walmart. Don't get me wrong, it is a great place to shop. Everything there is dirt cheap and you can literally get anything. So in the place's defense, I'm actually not mocking it. I'm actually just mocking the eating habits of the United States. People didn't buy this stuff, they wouldn't sell it. And I'm not sure it would be much different over here, to be honest. Maybe it's a chicken or the egg thing, I don't know. I mean, if there was a 32-ounce bag of Fruit Loops sitting on the shelf in the shop, I'd probably end up buying it, not gonna lie. As for the actual touristy shit we did when we were there, because I went with Dadpad, we stayed at Treasure Island, and I have to say I was quite disappointed at how unpiratey it was. I thought, you know, there'd be people in eye patches and tricorns and all kinds of shit. You know, epaulettes, parrots, swords. I thought there would be like roving people trying to steal my chips, but no, none of that. They had a couple of shows in-house as well there, actually. We saw Mystère, which is a Cirque du Soleil show. They said don't film it, but I did anyway because I'm a rebel me, right? Basically just homosexuals doing backflips. There wasn't any mistakes. Best part of the show was a fat guy in a nappy. Not joking. It was awesome. We also saw Blue Man Group, surprisingly eating-centric. It was basically guys in blue latex. They kind of had that makeup face paint put on, and then it turns to a latex layer face mask. So hence, it doesn't come off. Hands is clearly not the same, because you can see the blue coming off on everything. You know, it's just awkward. I don't know why they do that, but it was like loads of percussion, kind of like slapstick physical humor, which I thought was hilarious. It's genuinely really fucking funny.
Before we went to Vegas, we downloaded the Honest Hearts DLC, so we got to take a trip up to Utah one day. That was a breathtaking day. It was also the day I forgot to put the CF card in my camera. We also discovered that day there is in fact something that Walmart don't sell. So that was a kick in the balls. Nevertheless, it was a very breathtaking landscape. The day was almost saved, in fact, when we met a little squirrel. You know, this squirrel is actually native to the United States. We have exactly the same in Britain, except it's native to the United States, but it immigrated over. It's called the American Bastard Squirrel. You see, we used to have these beautiful red squirrels, but then this bastard grey infestation came over and drove them all out and stole their nuts, literally and figuratively. Now they only live on the Isle of Wight and Isle of Man. So yeah, fuck you, squirrel. In regards to the weather, when we were there, it was mostly sunny, despite being early March, but I mean, it's the middle of the desert, it should be. Having said that, on the first day, it actually rained pretty heavily, and Vegas is going to lose some points for that. You may say that's not fair on the city, but you know what? If you're going to put escalators in the open air that don't work when it rains, then you better make sure it never fucking rains. I gotta say, it was pretty funny that day it actually did rain, because there was just no one around. There's just the two British guys standing in the middle of the street, just like, yeah, it's just like home. It was funny watching how there was just no drainage in the road. There was just these deluges going down the curbs. Also, most of the hotels and malls are connected by bridges and hallways, and quite a lot of them have got marble floors, which if you've got wet feet, you just fucking fall over on. The whole city is just not geared towards rain at all. It was a weird day.
I think that's about everything now. So, in summary, the landscape is breathtaking, the shrubbery is interesting, the people are fat, the toilets have too much water in them, the roads are nice, their wildlife are bastards. Thank you for watching. Being a returning member to the Knights Templar, I was made an officer probably before I should have been. I found myself endowed with an ill-deserved sense of confidence early on, and it was when the guild needed us to get some metal, I decided I would captain a mission to go and get some. So I decided to take the Resurrection out, which at the time was one of three ships that was larger than a sloop. And as you can probably tell by the way this music is reaching a crescendo, it did not go fucking well. In Alien Isolation, you hide from a walking crustacean aboard a space station. You play as Ellen Ripley's blood relation of a younger generation, and her vocation includes communication and computation.
We arrive at the space habitation and immediately we feel the presence of the aberration. It seems like the place is in a state of sedation, or perhaps there's been some kind of widespread evacuation. It's hard to tell because there's no narration or orientation, but it seems like there's probably a correlation between the recently received information of Ripley Sr. and the current operation. Initially, there's several confrontations between folks without any kind of social organization, and all they really want to do is not die from exceberation, laceration, immolation, penetration, or strangulation, which goes a long way to explain their exasperation and agitation. Quite frankly, I can't say I blame them.
Yeah.